Hey guys, I'm John Setzler. Welcome back to the Kamado Joe Cooking Channel. Today we are going to revisit an older recipe that I've done, and we're going to turn it up several notches and really make some improvement on the smoked macaroni and cheese. So let's get started. Okay, to get this party started, I have lit a fire in the firebox of my Kamado Joe Classic, and I'm going to put just two chunks of apple wood on here to get a little bit of smoke rolling, and then I'm going to set my divide and conquer flexible cooking rack in place with the heat deflectors in the low position and the grill grates in the upper position, and we're going to stabilize this grill at about 350 degrees. In order to stabilize at 350, I'm going to leave the bottom vent about halfway open, and I'm going to close the slider on the top all the way, and I'm going to leave the daisy wheel fully open, and we'll watch from here, and if I need to warm it up, I'll open the slider a little, or if I need to cool it down, I'll close the daisy wheel. So we're going to stabilize here at 350. Okay, while our grill's heating up, I'm getting the macaroni ready, and what I've done here is I have gone ahead and cooked the macaroni. We started out with 2 cups of uncooked elbow macaroni, and I've got it drained out, and we're going to go back to this stock pot and put the rest of this together. And I'm going to start out with 4 eggs, 1 cup of milk, 1/2 cup of sour cream, 1 teaspoon of salt, 1/2 teaspoon of black pepper, and here I have 1.5 chipotle peppers that come canned in the adobo sauce, and I have chopped those up finely. And what we're going to do right here is just going to whisk all this together, get those eggs broken up, and get everything combined. And once that's combined, we're going to add our macaroni back in. And to that, I'm going to add 1 cup of shredded Gouda cheese and 1 cup of shredded cheddar cheese. And then we're going to mix all that together. And once we have all that mixed together, we are going to put it in our baking pan. And I'm just using a 9x9 baking pan. It's about 2 inches deep. We're going to put all this in here, and we're going to spread it out evenly. And then I've got 4 tablespoons of butter that I've cut into squares. We're just gonna layer that out on top here. And then I'm gonna top this with a little bit of extra shredded cheddar. And then I'm gonna grate on a little bit of Parm on top of that, a little bit of fresh grated Parmesan just to top that off. And now this bad boy is ready to go to the grill. Okay, our grill's up to temperature, so I'm gonna crack the lid on it here. We're gonna set this pan right in the middle, and we're gonna let this go for roughly 30 minutes. I'm not sure exactly how long it's gonna take, but we're gonna get a good cook on it, and I'll let you know as soon as we get there. Okay guys, we've been cruising along right here, right about 30 minutes, and I believe this guy's ready. I'm gonna take this off, we're gonna take it inside and let it cool for a little bit, and then we're gonna dive in. All right guys, this is done and it looks really good. So I'm gonna pull out a little corner here and we're gonna have a taste test. All right guys, it smells amazing. So let's dig in here, see what we've got. That's perfect. Perfect flavor. The chipotle pepper here brings a really interesting flavor. It does not make this spicy. It just really wakes it up. So give that a try. And if you don't think you'd like it, just leave it out. But you got to try this new version of the smoked mac and cheese. Give it a try. Let me know what you think. Join us on Facebook, facebook.com/KamadoJoe. Follow us on Twitter @KamadoJoe. And until next time, this is John Setzler with Kamado Joe Cooking Channel.